The vision was set for an appointed time, and when the time came, the vision spoke. The perfect place was established, the redeemed Christian Church of God, Messiah's place.
Started since 2017. The mother church, we have the intention of creating a model or a replica of the church we had then. That is Messiah's Priest Sanctuary. So we wanted to build the same brand, the same structure, the same thing that operates in Messiah's Priest Sanctuary. So, and that was what brought about Messiah's
Priest. Although when we were living Messiah's Priest Sanctuary, it was said that close to 30 or 28 workers were sent down here, in which the children, our children, were counted part of the workforce. So funny. But we thank God, the average population of the church as of today will be 70 something compared to when we started.
I remember when we started looking around, got to Sherry along there, Sherry will be. So we got some places there, very beautiful place. But unfortunately, or let me say fortunately, God was not speaking in that direction. We got a place, we would have been in a beer salon, you know. But then, God in His mercy decided to reroute us down to London. We just sent some people to London, we found this place. And that was how everything started. And the glory of the people, and everybody, God has given us this.
God has been awesome in all sense. In all sense, God has really been faithful. The church, even though it just been to the church has been able to do a lot. God has really given us a lot of plans to come. And He has really been the best that a lot of people for them to attain, you know, wherever, whatever they want to achieve. So God has really been faithful.
You should know that youth are very energetic, you know, and you won't expect that a youth church will run like a conventional church. You know, there are a lot of things that we do, especially on some national dates like February. That youth want to, they want to, things that are happening outside the church. Youth want, even the people in the church also want to do the same. But then they found a way of making people to do whatever they want to do in the confine of the presence of God.
I think God has given us a soft landing in Mako. God has given us the right set of people, people that He has placed His work in their hearts. We don't have to really do a lot of work to get people to do what they need to do. People are already coming and they're the ones telling us, oh, Pastor, God is laying upon our heart to do this, God is laying upon our heart to do that. And then it's making the work easy.
Those are the physical things that we could see and talk about. how much more of those that happen in the spiritual realm. I just want to say thank God. It's been awesome period, it's been awesome time. We've been together as a family, we've never had any cause to mourn over any one of us in this family. What the good news is, if anybody should be missed, the couple that we did, either they are going for a greater thing, possibly the person got married, the person has to go, the person needs to relocate, because the person has gotten another job, the person is going for further, the person is just for the what he has to do.
Initially, I met 7 children, but now, by the grace of God, we are recording up to 22 children. Then also, we bless God that since I've joined them, we don't have to force to bury any child. We appreciate God that God is answering our prayer. All the children in their various schools, they are doing excellently well. And since then, also, God also is adding to us all our pregnant women. They are delivering safe and sound. We don't have cause to mourn. We don't have cause to mourn the mother and the child. Also, we appreciate God that we now have crash. We in Sunday school. Initially, we have one teacher. Now we are 3 teachers supervising the children. And to the glory of God, we are doing fine, excellent. And with the help of the pastors, spiritually they are also growing. By the grace of God, some children that they can't even open their Bible from where they were coming from. And if you can boast of some children now, that they can boldly recite and open Bible, even without little or no supervision. The first and last,
you're the first and last. We are going to be focusing on leadership and discipleship next year, because you know a lot of people want to become leaders, but you can't be a leader if you have not been a disciple. You won't know how to lead, right? You will not understand how to lead if you have not been a disciple. So we want to focus on leadership and discipleship, then also on family ways. We want to look at family issues and matters that affect families. We want to look at that because we understand, although we are youth church, but at the same time, a lot of us are getting married, are giving back to children, so we need to know how this thing works.
In 2019 and 2018, we were able to reach about 200 people in CSR. In 2020, we want to double that, one about times 10 of that. We want to be able to reach the people that really matter, the people that need it. Not just for the record, not just so that people say, oh, Ms. Askins has done this. No. It's also a proof that God is developing us, that God is increasing us. We are platforms to do great things. We are doubling it, we are increasing it, and reaching more people for Christ. That is exactly what we want to do. And then once you reach more people online, offline, and you share. We love you.